Hello and welcome to Living Black, coming to you from Sydney. I'm Carla Grant. In today's program, Anthony Mundine opens up about his comments on the Aboriginal people of Tasmania.
It hit a worse nerve with the people down there, which rightfully so.
Will Kenya wages war on tooth decay?
Going from the 19 out of 21 to 2 out of 21 requiring treatment, I think that's where you want to be.
And we check out the circus with an Indigenous troupe of performers.
Some blackfellas are really smart. They can flip like that, you know, or they can make people laugh like that.
A project to build new homes on Queensland's Mornington Island is underway, but locals have raised concerns about the quality of the homes and a lack of employment opportunities around the construction.
Just off the coast of Queensland in the Gulf of Carpentaria lies Mornington Island. With a population of around 1,200 people, it's one of many Indigenous communities around Australia earmarked to receive new homes. The project is part of the Aboriginal Housing National Partnership Agreement on Remote Indigenous Housing, a $5.5 billion nationwide commitment over 10 years made by the Prime Minister at the time, Kevin Rudd.
We're trying to eliminate the overcrowding and stuff like that. So we've got 20 new houses that's been proposed to us. State government.
20 homes are not even half of what was promised. Now the community is wondering if the state government will deliver the other 37.
Mornington Island's currently under a 40-year lease that was signed by the previous state government, who promised block housing like the ones behind me. But what's being delivered by the new government currently are flat packs.
Flat packs are easily assembled kit homes, and locals say they're of limited benefit to the community.
These flat pack homes that they are offering us now, it's not the way to go. Like, they're offering us flat pack homes which would be built in like 6 weeks, and what sort of training and training opportunities or job opportunities there is for our local mob, there's nothing, you know.
You can't really do apprenticeship on
you
a
can't do week. Apprenticeship, you know, you might be probably a qualified maintenance maker, you know, maintenance person, so drilling holes in the wall is easy, anybody can do that.
Mr. Wilson says his community needs the job opportunities and money. Instead, it is being contracted to the government's housing construction company, QBuild.
You know, what's going to happen is these mob come into the community with their trades, do the job, and then they're gone, you know. So they're taking the money out of the community, they're not putting anything back into the community. It's all about job security for our mob too as well, you know.
Durability of the housing is also an issue for the mayor.
Because this is Cyclone Alley alleyway for us, like, we get cyclone nearly every season that comes through here.
The Queensland Government says it's preparing a response to the Mornington Island community's concerns. In the meantime, construction of the kit homes will continue.
NITV news journalist Charmaine Ingram with that report. Still to come on Living Black, Anthony Mundine explains those comments about Aboriginal Tasmanians.